Okay, so I'm going to show you some energy conversion systems. See, in this case, when this child starts cycling, this turbine of generator starts rotating. And look at the level of mercury in the thermometer on right hand side. I increase the speed. Level of mercury in the thermometer is rising. Okay, and you see water starts boiling and steam starts coming out of it. So see, conversion of energy is taking place. When the child is bicycling, he is using muscular energy. And due to that muscular energy, the wheels of cycle and turbine of generator start rotating. So kinetic energy is there. Muscular energy is converted into kinetic energy. And then after that, it is converted into heat energy of boiling water. Okay, we can have some other systems as well. In place of, suppose, this water, we are having this bulb. Okay, so let us check it out, whether it happens now also. I replace this system also and this source also. So this is sunlight falling on solar cell panel, and you can see the electrical energy produced is used up in lighting the bulb. So solar energy is converted into electrical energy by the solar cell panel. And after that, that electrical energy is used to light the bulb. So it is converted into heat energy and light energy. We can do one more thing. We can replace the source by this pressure cooker. And again, the steam will fall on this turbine. I'll start heating now. And again, let's replace it by the same water system. Now, when I will turn the burner on, this steam produced by the cooker, that is converted into kinetic energy of turbine of generator, and slowly water will start getting heated up and the level of mercury is rising. In the thermometer, you can see that. And after some time, water starts boiling also. So you can see the steam coming out of that container. Is that clear? So these are different energy conversion systems. Okay, these are different energy conversion systems. Clear? So let us resume back. And now we are going to derive kinetic energy, formula of kinetic energy. Okay, any definition, if it is not clear, you can ask students. If any definition was not clear to you, you can ask first. Raise your hand if it is not clear. Yes, still students are entering. Okay. So let us start with the derivation of kinetic energy. But before that, who will tell me the formula for kinetic energy first? Yes. Define kinetic energy. We defined all the types of energy yesterday, right? So who will do that? Yes, Anshia. Aap batao.
Kinetic energy is the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its motion.
Yes, by virtue of its motion. So now we are allowing an object to move, and let us see how much energy it stores in the form of kinetic energy. So let us assume an object of mass M lying at rest on a smooth table. Whatever I'm speaking, you have to write in the beginning of your derivation, right? Because you are not supposed to do only the mathematical portion, you are to write the situation as well, what we are taking. So we are taking an object of mass M lying at rest. It is lying at rest, that's why we have taken U0 on a smooth table. Smooth table means friction is absent here, right? Now a force acts on it and displaces it through certain displacement. The displacement produced is S, suppose, and the object starts moving because of that force. It starts moving with the final velocity V, means the object gets accelerated. Okay, any example of this situation is, for example, there is a ball lying at rest on a table, and then you apply a force, it starts moving with some final velocity v. So since we have allowed the object to move, the work done will be stored in the form of kinetic energy on account of its motion. So we are going to find that kinetic energy. And remember, whenever we will calculate any energy, we will always start with work. So सबसे पहले हम work से ही start करेंगे, वही work energy की form में store होता है. Always remember this. Okay? So let us write by definition of work. We will start with work. By definition of work, W is equal to Fs. We need not write cos 0 here because it is understood that force and displacement are taking place in the same direction. So cos 0 is 1. Okay. W is equal to Fs. Now, according to Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma. According to Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma. So put it here. Put in equation number 1, we get W is equal to MAS. We call it equation number 2. See, if these two steps are not clear, you can ask. Are these two steps clear to you? Pehle humne work likha, then we have substituted F is equal to MA in it. Okay, F is equal to MA in it. I hope this step is clear. After that, from third equation of motion, v square minus u square equal to 2as. Using third equation of motion, v square minus u square equal to 2as, put u equal to 0 because we have taken the object at rest. So v square minus v 0 square is 2as. 0 means nothing. So v square minus nothing is v square is equal to 2as. Is this step clear? If any step is not clear, you can raise your hand. Okay, you can raise your hand. Okay, so after this, take 2 in the denominator. You have v square over 2 is equal to as. Take 2 in the denominator, we get v square over 2 equal to as. Value of as is v square over 2. Yes, Chaitanya, you want to ask something?
Ma'am, third equation wala ek bar fir se samjha do.
Haan ji.
Ma'am, jo third equation wala hai, वो एक बार फिर से बता दो.
ओके, थर्ड इक्वेशन पता है ना आपको, v स्क्वायर माइनस u स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 2as. उसमें हमने u को 0 पुट कर दिया बिकॉज़ वी हैव टेकन द ऑब्जेक्ट एट रेस्ट. तो u स्क्वायर 0 हो गया, तो यहां पे सिर्फ v स्क्वायर रह गया ना ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. सो v स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 2as. उसके बाद 2 हम इधर ले गए तो अकेला as रह गया. सो as इज v स्क्वायर अपॉन 2. As is v square by 2. Now put this value of As here in equation number 2. So put As equal to v square by 2 in equation number 2. This is our next step. Kyunki aap dekh rahe ho ki As kiske equal aya? V square by 2 ke equal aya. So put it there. Put As equal to v square by 2 in equation number 2. Then we get W is equal to M as such. Okay. We will not disturb this. And in place of AS, we will put V square by 2. In place of AS, we will substitute V square by 2. So this becomes half MV square. And since this work has been done to move the object from one place to another place, this work can be written as kinetic energy. So this is a formula for kinetic energy. half mv square. And this is the derivation. Okay, so have a look at the complete derivation of kinetic energy. So we get the formula, kinetic energy is half mv square. Is that okay? After this, next is work energy theorem. It's a related article, so we'll be doing just now before potential energy, right? Work energy theorem. Now, what is that? Whenever work is done, force is applied on an object, work is done. Okay? You know that whenever force acts on an object, work is done. And work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. This is work energy theorem. Jab bhi work perform hoga, ऑब्जेक्ट की काइनेटिक एनर्जी चेंज हो जाएगी, ठीक है? दिस इज कॉल्ड वर्क एनर्जी थ्योरम. लिखिए स्टेटमेंट, राइट डाउन. व्हेन फोर्स एक्ट्स ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट वर्क इज डन. व्हेन फोर्स एक्ट्स ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट वर्क इज डन एंड वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू Work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. Work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. This is called work energy theorem. Let us explain it. ठीक है, इसको मैं साइड पे एक्सप्लेन कर दूँ. So according to our statement, work is change in kinetic energy. Change means फाइनल काइनेटिक एनर्जी माइनस इनिशियल काइनेटिक एनर्जी. वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी. आगे लिखिए दैट इज वर्क इज इक्वल टू फाइनल काइनेटिक एनर्जी माइनस इनिशियल काइनेटिक एनर्जी. राइट दिस स्टेप हियर. यस चैतन्य,
प्लीज रिपीट द क्वेश्चन.
व्हाट? क्या? Yes, what are you saying?
Repeat the question, please. Question repeat कर दो.
क्या आवाज audible है?
मैम question repeat कर दो.
Repeat करूँ? Okay. Work energy theorem states that whenever force acts on an object, work is done, and work done is equal to change in kinetic energy of the body. Work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. When force acts on an object, work is done, and work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. This is work energy theorem. आगे लिखिए, that is work done is equal to final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Final kinetic energy, how you will write? Half mv square. And how will you write initial kinetic energy? Half mu square. You will write half mu square. If you use initial velocity, it will become initial kinetic energy. So if the formula for final kinetic energy is half mv square, then the formula for initial kinetic energy is half mu square. Okay, so let us take m and 2 common out of it. Then that means this is the formula of work energy theorem. So this is the formula of work energy theorem. Note it down. Now you can use directly in numerical problems. W is equal to m by 2 v square minus u square. So learn this formula by heart. You can directly use in numerical problems now. So this is a formula coming from work energy theorem. Now let us start with the proof of work energy theorem. ये तो होगी statement और formula. अब इसका proof कैसे करना है? बिल्कुल वैसे ही करना है like we did the derivation of kinetic energy. Just the difference is that initial velocity u is not zero. The object is not starting from rest. So let us assume an object already moving with some initial velocity. हो सकता है ऐसे? Yes, हो सकता है. पहले से कोई चीज मूव करती आ रही है हमारे पास, हम एक और पुश लगा के उसकी स्पीड को चेंज कर देते हैं. दैट्स इट, राइट? सो द ऑब्जेक्ट इज नॉट एट रेस्ट नाउ. So consider an object of mass m moving with initial velocity u on a smooth table. A force acts on the object and changes its velocity from u to v. The object gets accelerated. So jab object accelerate ho gayi hai, to uski velocity change ho rahi hai bas. That's the thing. So sorry, derivation bilkul same hai. Aap fir se yahin se start kar do. Theek hai, write all the steps again. But the change is here that u is not zero. Since u is not zero, hum as such isko likhenge and we will take 2 under it. V square minus u square over 2 will be equal to as now. Now as will not be equal to v square by 2. Now as will be v square minus u square by 2. Got it? As will be v square minus u square by 2. Yahan pe u square bhi aayega. So when we put this as in equation number 2, we'll put as equal to v square minus u square by 2. तो यहाँ पे v square minus u square आ जाएगा. बस ये हमारा formula है. So this is our formula. This is your complete derivation. Note it down. Same steps hain. Bas u ko zero nahi lena hai. Bas. Do it now. This is work energy theorem. We'll do the exercise. Then we will use this formula. Okay, fine. Yes. What is gravitational potential energy? Kaun batayega? What is gravitational potential energy? How do we define this? Yes, student. What is gravitational potential energy? ओके गुरुपाल आप बताओ.
मैम एनर्जी पोजेस्ड बाय एन ऑब्जेक्ट ड्यू टू चेंज इन इट्स पोजीशन.
यस ड्यू टू चेंज इन पोजीशन. एनी एग्जांपल
मैम अ स्टोन लाइंग ऑन द रूफ ऑफ द हाउस.
यस यस वाटर स्टोन इन डैम्स. बुक लाइंग ऑन अ टेबल. स्टोन लाइंग ऑन द रूफ ऑफ हाउस. ऑल दीज आर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी.
वाटर स्टोर्ड इन डैम.
हाँ वाटर स्टोर्ड इन डैम. ये सभी किसके एग्जाम्पल्स हैं? ग्रेविटेशनल पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. ठीक है अब हम उसका फॉर्मूला डिराइव करेंगे. राइट नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव अ फॉर्मूला. सो लेट अस कंसिडर एन ऑब्जेक्ट एट अ हाइट एच फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड. दिस इज ग्राउंड लेवल. Now consider an object lying at a height h from the ground. An object is lying here. For example, a book is lying on a table. Okay? For example, a book is lying on a table at a height h. What is the gravitational force acting on it? Weight. Its weight is acting in the downward direction. ठीक है? तो इसका weight downward direction में act कर रहा है. All right. So in this case, the force acting is weight. And if we drop this object through this height h, how much distance will it cover? It will cover a distance equal to the height through which it falls. Okay. It will cover a distance through a height equal to height through which it falls. Fine. So how much work is done by us to drop an object through a height h? So hum isko yahan se yahan leke aana chahte hain. Table se ground pe leke aana chahte hain. We want to change its position now. So in this case, the work done will be stored in the form of gravitational potential energy because we want to change the position of the object, right? So in this case, the work done is how much? Fs, this is the formula work done. Put the values here. F is mg and s is h. So in this case, mgh amount of work will be done and it will be stored in the form of gravitational potential energy, because this work has been done to change the position of the object. So that's why it is stored in the form of gravitational potential energy. So this is a two-step derivation of gravitational potential energy, very small derivation. Okay, it's a very small derivation. ठीक है, कोई डाउट इसमें? एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क स्टूडेंट. ग्रेविटेशनल पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, द अदर टाइप ऑफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज इलास्टिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. एंड इलास्टिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज एनर्जी पोजेस्ड बाय एन ऑब्जेक्ट ड्यू टू चेंज इन शेप. लाइक आई गेव यू एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ कंप्रेस्ड स्प्रिंग, स्ट्रेच्ड रबर बैंड, स्ट्रेच्ड बो. तो इन सभी में कौन सी एनर्जी स्टोर्ड है? इलास्टिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. उसका हमने डेरिवेशन नहीं करनी है, जस्ट फॉर योर इंफॉर्मेशन आई विल टेल यू इट्स फॉर्मूला. तो फॉर्मूला नोट कर लीजिए. इलास्टिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, इट्स फॉर्मूला इज हाफ के एक्स स्क्वेयर, हाफ के एक्स स्क्वेयर. वेयर व्हाट इज के? के इज स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट. के इज कॉल्ड स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट. It's a constant different for different springs. And x is extension produced in the spring. आप spring को stretch करते हो तो वो extend हो जाता है ना. तो कितनी extension उसमें produce होती है, कितना stretch होता है, उसको हम कहते हैं extension in the spring. Do you remember Hooke's law? I once mentioned it. कौन बताएगा कि कहाँ पे mention किया था? बस इतना बता दो, don't tell me the law. बट ये बता दो कि कहां पे हमने मेंशन किया था हुक्स लॉ. इफ यू रिमेंबर हुक्स लॉ, यस, हु विल टेल मी हुक्स लॉ? कहीं सुना है आपने? डू यू रिमेंबर स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट, जब बताया था कि वेट इज मेजर्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट. तो स्प्रिंग कांस्टेंट जो है उसके पीछे स्प्रिंग लगा होता है, आपको लैब में दिखाया भी था, है ना? तो इट इज बेस्ड ऑन हुक्स लॉ, द वर्किंग ऑफ स्प्रिंग, स्प्रिंग बैलेंस, दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन हुक्स लॉ. अब वो क्या होता है? सपोज वी हैव अ स्प्रिंग, नॉर्मल स्प्रिंग. अभी हमने इसको स्ट्रेच नहीं किया हुआ, एक्सटेंशन जीरो है. नाउ वी एक्सटेंडेड, वी अप्लाई अ फोर्स ऑन इट, इट गेट्स एक्सटेंडेड. अब हमने इसके ऊपर फोर्स लगाया, एंड एक्सटेंशन प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द स्प्रिंग इज एक्स. दिस इज द अप्लाइड फोर्स, हमने फोर्स अप्लाई किया. सो व्हेन वी विल रिलीज इट, व्हाई डज द स्प्रिंग कम बैक? बिकॉज़ अ रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स प्रोड्यूसेस विद इन द स्प्रिंग. अपने आप एक रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स प्रोड्यूस हो जाता है स्प्रिंग के अंदर, दैट ट्राइज टू रिस्टोर इट्स ओरिजिनल पोजिशन. तो जो इसको वापस लेके आता है अपनी ओरिजिनल पोजिशन, that force is called restoring force. चलो वो जितना भी है, it is directly proportional to extension. मतलब extension is directly proportional to the force that we apply. तो यहां से F is equal to minus kx formula आ जाता है हमारे पास. This is called Hooke's formula. तो ये Hooke's law है, कुछ भी नहीं है. मतलब आप imagine कर सकते हो कि क्या है Hooke's law, कि when we apply force on a spring, it gets extended. ओके, वी इंक्रीज द फोर्स, ठीक है, और एक्सटेंशन ऑल्सो इंक्रीज. मतलब एक्सटेंशन इन द स्प्रिंग इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द फोर्स दैट वी अप्लाई. जितना फोर्स हम ज्यादा अप्लाई करेंगे, उतनी ही ज्यादा एक्सटेंशन स्प्रिंग में प्रोड्यूस होगी. तो ये तो कॉमन सेंस की बात है, कोई नथिंग सो स्पेशल अबाउट इट. बट यू रिमेंबर दिस इज कॉल्ड हुक्स लॉ. और वही वाला जो के है जो यहाँ पे आता है स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट, वो हमारी इलास्टिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी में भी यूज होता है. क्योंकि हम शेप की चेंज की बात कर रहे हैं, तो स्प्रिंग सबसे पहला एग्जांपल है व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द चेंज इन शेप। तो ये डेरिवेशन हमने करनी थी इलास्टिक और ग्रेविटेशनल पोटेंशियल एनर्जी की। अब कल हम करेंगे नेक्स्ट इसके बाद ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ एनर्जी एंड कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी, लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी, दैट आर द लास्ट टॉपिक। ठीक है, तो वो हम करेंगे, उसके बाद एक्सरसाइज करेंगे, देन आवर सिलेबस विल बी ओवर। Right? Yes. Any doubts from your side now? You can ask. कोई doubt है तो पूछ लो बच्चे।